What we're going to do here is show you how to make a line graph in Excel using some pretend data from a pretend experiment. What we happen to do in this pretend experiment is that we wanted to see how exposure to UV radiation affects the number of mutant cells that appear in three different bacterial populations. So the first thing to do when making a line graph in Excel is to figure out which values you'd like to plot along your x-axis or the horizontal axis. And by convention, it's the independent variable that gets plotted along the x-axis. So in this pretend experiment, the independent variable happened to be the amount of time that the bacteria were exposed to UV radiation. And so after you figured out which values you'd like to plot along your x-axis, type those values into the far left-hand column, like I've done here. The next step then is to type in the values that you'd like to be plotted along your y-axis, or the vertical axis. In other words, these are going to be your dependent variable values. And so in this pretend experiment, the dependent variable is the amount or the number of mutant cells that appeared. And so it's those values that you'd like plotted along the y-axis. Those get inputted in the column here to the right of where you put the independent variable values. And so in this particular experiment, we're going to want to compare directly the number of mutant cells that appear in three different populations. So in other words, you're looking at three different conditions that you'd like to compare directly to one another. So when that's the case, where you have three different data sets that you'd like to plot on the same graph, then what you do is you type in the Y values for each one of those data sets adjacent to one another, like I've done here. So after you have your x-axis values typed in, and after you have your y-axis values typed in, the next step is to tell Excel to make a graph out of all of your numbers. You do that by highlighting everything you just typed in. Go up to Insert. To make a line graph, go to Scatter, and then select the one where the points are connected by a smooth line. When you do that, there's a chance that the preview graph that you'll see won't look anything like you're expecting. And so if that's the case, there's a quick fix. Just go up to this Switch Row Column button. So if by default that's clicked a certain way, the preview graph you'll see, again, won't look anything like what you're expecting it to look like. So to fix it, just click on this button, and that should make it look as expected. The next step is to go to Chart Layouts and select the one that's called Layout Number 1. The reason why I like Layout Number 1 is because it gives you placeholders where you can just type in the title for your graph as well as labels for your x-axis and the y-axis. So basically you're done with your graph. The last things to do then is to go ahead and put in those labels. I think it helps to enlarge the graph a little bit so you can type things in easier. To add in an appropriate x-axis title, just click on this and type it in. Then do the same thing for the y-axis. And then type in an appropriate chart title. One thing I usually do is enlarge the size of the font for the x and the y-axis labels. So by default, they're kind of small. So to make it bigger, if you click on it, then go up to Home, and then enlarge the font from 10 to something like maybe 11 or 12. That's easier to read. You can do that with both axes labels. And then one more thing that I usually do is, so you see that there is a legend here that tells you what each one of these lines corresponds to. I think it's actually easier to read if you put in these labels directly on the graph itself. So the way to do that is by going over to Insert, Shapes, and then select the one for Text Box. And then you can produce a text box right on the graph itself. And so then you can type in what each one of these lines corresponds to. Once you have your labels in, then you can get rid of this key by right-clicking on it and then selecting Delete. And when you do that, you might have to fix the location of these labels that you just put in. One other useful tool might be to enlarge your graph to make it easier to read. In other words, you can make it so that it takes up the entire page instead of just a small portion of the page like you see right now. The way to do that is by right-clicking somewhere in your graph, then select move chart to a new sheet. And when you do that, you'll see that it now takes up the entire page. So if you were to print it out, for example, it'll look pretty big. So the last thing we'll show you how to do is how to insert a linear regression line among your data points. And so you saw earlier why using a linear regression or a best fit straight line might be handy in certain situations. So say that you'd like to insert a linear regression for your data points that represent your E. coli data set. The way to do that is by selecting on any of the points that you see along the line and right-clicking it. Select the option for Add Trend Line. Make sure that the one for linear is clicked into place. And I actually think it's helpful to have Excel display the equation of the trend line on the chart. When you do that, you'll see that there is now a trend line and there's the equation for it. Sometimes it might be hard to see the trend line because it's a lot thinner as compared to the smooth line that's connecting all the dots. So one thing you could do to make the trend line easier to see is to right click somewhere along it, go to Format Trend Line, and just make it thicker. And the way you can do that is by going to Line Style and then jacking the width up from the default 0.75 to maybe something like 2.5. And so when you do that, that trend line becomes a lot more apparent. And so that's how you make a line graph in Excel.